Okay. Hey everyone, I'm gonna get started now. I've 100%ed Crash 2 and 3, but I am not doing Wrath of Cortex. I'm not familiar with this game at all, so I don't want to waste too much time, and I want to try and get some sleep tonight. So let's get this all set up. I do remember playing this one a bunch on GameCube as a kid. I don't remember too much about it, though. I have some faint memories of it, like the third boss fight and certain levels. But I never fully completed this game. I only did the first boss fight. I never did all the relics. And Universal Interactive Studios production. I don't think I enjoyed this one as much as Crash 3. Traveler's Tales.
Crash Bandicoot, the Wrath of Cortex.
Let's get the name in.
Fools! Nincompoops! Can't you idiots do anything right? According to this, your track record for spreading evil is pathetic!
Ooka Ooka, it's not our fault that wretched Bandicoot is to blame!
I will not let anything stand in the way of evil, especially not a brainless orange marsupial! Crash must be eliminated!
Ooka Ooka, need I remind you that Crash always finds a way to defeat us? Maybe he's just too good for us.
Enough excuses! You five idiots need to come up with one good plan! Or else...
How do I get into these situations?
There must be something we can come up with. Say, Doctor... Haven't you been tinkering with some kind of new secret weapon in your laboratory?
I don't know what you're talking about, Entropy.
Dr. Cortex! I think he's referring to this super secret weapon you've been laboring over day and night since the last time Crash defeated you.
Enough bickering! Do we have a plan?
Well, in my scientific endeavors, I've been able to create a genetically advanced super weapon of unbelievable strength. But the power source is the final missing crucial element. Element. Elements. Yes! The elementals! Right! The elementals, that's it! If released, their destructive energy could create enough power to bring my secret weapon to life. We'd have a weapon capable of crushing mountains, demolishing entire cities! And wiping Crash Bandicoot off the face of the earth forever! Get ready to face my wrath, Crash Bandicoot!
No, it cannot be. Oh, no.
What's going on? Oh, no. Crash, look out.
Ha, why does everything about this game just look so bad?
It appears that my evil twin brother Uka Uka is up to his no good tricks again. I must find out what he is planning.
How does a PS1 game look better than this?
Hello, my feeble brother.
You have gotten my attention, Uka Uka. What kind of diabolical scheme do you and Dr. Cortex have planned this time?
No schemes. Just some old familiar faces dropping by for a visit.
No, not the elementals. Uka Uka, why did you release them? Don't you know what happened the last time they were free?
So they were responsible for a few earthquakes, floods, and that little ice age a couple of centuries back. You worry too much, brother.
You cannot restrain them, Uka Uka. They are far too dangerous. This could spell disaster for us all.
On the contrary, Aku Aku. It spells disaster for you and that precious planet you care so much about. Destroy him!
You won't get away with this.
Who's going to stop us?
Crash, Coco, it is just as I feared. Uka Uka and Dr. Cortex have freed a group of destructive masks known as the Elementals. We must find a way to stop them before they destroy the Earth and all of its inhabitants. The only way to stop the Elementals' destructive nature is to imprison them with the use of ancient crystals. Each Elemental can be returned back to their hibernation state with a total of 5 crystals. We must act quickly. Coco, what is the status of the new portal chamber you've been working on?
It's almost finished. A few little adjustments here and there, and it'll be ready to go.
Well done, Coco. This gives us the ideal opportunity to test it. We must hurry.
So I do want to point out, though, that all of the elementals have pretty
Crash
great voice actors
Bandicoot,
lined
my old
up.
Nemesis, how the heck are you? Still gathering crystals? Old habits die hard, don't they? My days are being spent on something much more intriguing. Meet Crunch, my newest creation.
This is the creature who keeps sabotaging your master plan? You gotta be kidding. I'll exterminate this field rat in no time.
Now, Crunch, your time with Crash will come soon enough. Isn't it brilliant? A testament to my true scientific genius. A real bandicoot warrior. Unlike you, Crash. Oh well, we all make mistakes. Ta-ta for now.
So, the first elemental we'll be going to... Oh, okay. I was having bad control issues with the GameCube version, so I'm glad this one's working fine. Because I switched to PS2 for this. So the first elemental we're going against is Rocco, and he's played by Tom Wilson, which is Biff from Back to the Future. We should hear his voice soon. Yeah.
What are you looking at, Fuzzhead? I'm Rocco, the Earth Elemental. Uka Uka and Dr. Cortex woke me from my captive slumber, and now I'm free to pulverize whatever gets in my way. Oh, don't even think about collecting those crystals, Runt. Because if you do, I'm going to bury you alive.
So yeah, like I said earlier, I'm not going to be 100% in this game. I'm just going to do a straight run through and get straight to Twin Sanity afterwards, because I'm not comfortable enough with this game. Okay, they removed the slide spin. That's bad. Oh, I guess it's mostly running, jumping, and spinning now. Hold on 1 second. Just needed to turn the volume up for myself because I do kind of like the music from what I've heard in this game before, and I just had it way too low for myself. Yeah, this game looks so weird. I know this was made under a really small time period, so they must have been crunched as hell, but it came out so rough looking. This first level's fine, but already I'm just feeling like it doesn't feel as good as Crash 2 and 3 did to play. I won't harp on this too long, but just very beginning making some comparisons since I just came off those two games. Oh right, this level had death pop. Very weird for the first level of the game to have a death pop. Get this life here. I might go back in to get the death path just to show what's there. Like, I'm still going to play a good chunk of this. I just don't want to go through and get the relics. I'm not comfortable enough to try and get those. Oh, right. They removed the dance. He just does a high jump now when he gets a gem. That's lame. One moment. What's the matter, Bandit? Okay, so I think I'm going to just give the first world a try before I go into, like, any huge, like, comparison to the other games. Just talk and just let these levels go for a little bit. Because I don't want to harp too much on, like, the differences between the games, but this is a sequel to them, and I just did just go through them. I do want to have a little bit of a talk about, like, just what's different between them and how they feel and function. Hi, Tay. Oh, I should have gotten rid of all these nitros before I came in here. That went smoothly. Easy enough there. Right, the second level of this is a aerial stage. This didn't come until the fourth world in Crash 3. Music's really nice though. Team. those other planes were the old enemies, right? I never realized that they'd just thrown into that level.
You want a piece of me, Bandicoot? Huh? Huh? Do ya? Wuss!
And now we got this ball level. This is fun. This is really fun. I like watching things spin at high speeds. Ooh, let's go back. I honestly have no, I don't remember how I felt playing much of this game as a kid. I remember playing it, I just don't remember if I liked it or not. I guess that just means it didn't really leave much of an impression on me. But again, like the last stage, the last two stages, this stage's music is really good. Why would you make that if nothing's there? Oh, that's the end of the stage. So, Nitro creeps up there. Oh, gosh, I almost went flying into that. Oh, I still have my Aku Aku hit points. They're just not visible. That's weird. That's really weird. I'd like to know how many hits I can take. And the gems, they're just... Why are they clear? That's not good. Yeah, that second path, I think it's just to... Maybe it's for the relic? It's a faster path? I don't know. Doesn't really serve a purpose other than just an alternate path to the end. If there were a couple normal crates on there, I would have got it, because it means you have to go through it to get the gem. But the other path just has all the boxes. I do remember liking this stage though. This stage has good music and a great chase. Yeah, this is a level with a dragon chase. Here it is. Right, it still tries to bite at you while it's stuck. I don't know if it actually can. Did it make an elephant's noise? That's an odd noise for a dragon. You don't get that often. Let's take the death route. See what's here. Okay, this death route locks you. That was a really easy death path. Okay, I like that. When you respawn, you see your box counter tallying back up. Thank you. It's just not as cool as doing the crash dance. I wish it was the crash dance instead of that high jump. I do like the high jump animation though.
Oh, I'm gonna shake, rattle, and roll your Bandicoot butt.
I remember this a lot. This is fun as well. And I think there's a level later on that's the same as that, but more intense. Yeah, it's all good ideas, it's just, it needed more time. I think they really had to rush this game out and they shouldn't have. They should have given it time to polish. Because I'll be honest, it's embarrassing that this is a PS2 game that doesn't look as good as a PS1 game. It's got the poly counts. But, just visually, it's not as impressive as Crash 2 and 3 were. Oh no. That got me. I wasn't expecting them to be TNTs. That's better. Actually get it cleared this time. Oh, what? Why was that only two bounces? Why was that first one only two bounces? Right, yellow gem path. I was just about to question why where that second gem was.
Looks like the Bandicoot's been busy collecting crystals. I warned you, Bandicoot.
Finally, I get to wrap my fingers around your puny orange neck.
I forget that Crunch is super aggressive in this game too. I remember this boss fight sucking though. Oh god. Oh no, he did it again. Okay, so I can touch them, but it'll do a little bit of damage. Hey, Zadari. Shit. There we go, finally. Now I have to do that two more times. Yeah, this fight blows. Jesus, I'm dead. I don't know how well it's coming across visually, but this blows to control. It's really hard to just maneuver around in this arena. Oh no. Get back here. There we go. And now we've got the most useless power up to ever be in a Crash game. Sneak.
Cortex! When are you and that super weapon of yours going to put an end to that interfering bandicoot? You are beginning to test my patience!
I'm working on a Duka Uka. Listen, Crash, you may have outsmarted Rocco, but there are three more elemental masks where he came from. And just as luck would have it, they are all significantly more powerful. Ha! I have no doubt that the water elemental, Wawa, will make sure you never see the light of day.
Yeah, the water boy and I are gonna take you out. Ooh, I'm gonna rip you limb from limb.
Yeah, I think the sneak is only used, like, twice in the main game. And, also, Wawa, where is he? Voiced by R. Lee Ernie. Alright, I said I was gonna do general impressions so far after the first world.
You've got some nerve setting foot into my domain without an invitation. Don't talk back to me! I'll fix that attitude problem of yours!
So he's usually typecast as, like, military generals. He's in Full Metal Jacket, he's Sergeant Hartman. And in Texas Chainsaw Massacre, he's Sheriff Hoyt. But yeah, okay, so after the first world, general impression so far, it's way floatier compared to 2 and 3. It also just kind of feels like a slower game in general because of the floatiness, and I don't think the run speed is as good as the others. And it's got good ideas. It does have good ideas. It just doesn't look or play as good as the older games, which is unfortunate. It could have been a better game just based on the ideas they had if they had time to finish it. Also, these levels are way too wide. Look, I can just... No issue with these enemies. They don't turn to aim at me. I just go off to the side and... they just leave me be. I also feel like they went a little more aggressive on the gimmicks than Crash 3 did. Because at First World we had two proper levels and a bunch of gimmicks. I guess the Crash 3 is the same there. But I don't really count the underwater levels as a gimmick level in 3. Yeah, we'll see. I know we'll see some more soon as well. We're gonna get another plane level in this hub. And we got a Jeep in this level, so it's not even a full, complete level on its own. It's got a gimmick thrown into it as well. Like, the fifth level in the first hub had that as well. You started off with the minecart and then went into a level. So here's the first use of the snake. Which a snake also goes into my point of it just feels like a slower paced game, because that's a slow power up. I also, just as a general control thing, I don't like that they remove the slide spin. I love doing the slide spin, and I just can't in this game, so it gives me less reason to slide around. Oh god. Kill me, rhinos. Now, let's go. We Okay, here's a swimming level. Oh god, where did that come from? Gotta be something over here. No, there isn't. Why would they set a trap there for no reason? Oh, I don't like this. There's foreground elements blocking your sights and they'll drop from the sky. Yeah, I just barely saw that. I didn't see that one at all. I just heard it going. Yeah, no, I'm gonna be doing all the platformers. So I'm gonna be doing, I'm going to try and do Wrath of Cortex and Twin Santy in one night. Oh, that's evil. Jesus. Yeah, I really like Twin Sanity as well. Oh, here we go. Give me 1 second. Okay, still has that. So I'm gonna have to put up... Oh, that just straight up broke it. Thank you. Alright, I'll be one moment, sorry. I fixed the issue. And yeah, that picture was really bad, which is why I had to use it for the Be Right Back screen. Yeah, I don't like these foreground elements blocking your view. Like these are really wide open levels, like vertically, so I feel like I've got to hug the top so I don't get bombarded by those dropping bombs. See, I'm hugging the top and I still didn't see that. This is really bad level design. It's not even that it's worse than the original trilogy, those are just bad decisions to make for this type of stage. And before this, I was enjoying the levels. I liked the handful of levels I did before this. Oh god, that was my bad. I kept going down even when I saw Nitros were there. Yeah, it just feels like it's full of beginner traps that aren't good. There's an invisible wall there, so you have to go underneath that. There's nothing over here. Why are they setting traps for the right side and not having anything over there? I think I fucked something up, so I can't get that box now. Yeah, two boxes. So, that was the first egregiously bad level. Everything else was good up to that point. And I know there's a level coming up here that I absolutely hate. This isn't it, though. I think I like this level.
Leave my levels alone!
Oh, right, the other thing I wanted to talk about when I was comparing the games is these mid-level boss quips aren't as good. Nowhere near as good as the ones that were in Warped. And it's very obvious this game's just trying to be Crash Bandicoot 3 again, because Crash 3 was what worked. Yeah, that one's super lazy. Oh, she doesn't have a slide, she has a little kick. I don't know why you'd ever use that little kick. It's low. Thank you. I'm also noticing something, like, we're, what, 8 levels deep into this game now? There's no level themes. We've just been going through different types of environments this entire time, which probably was part of the reason why this game lacks polish. If they had just decided on a bunch of level themes, maybe they could have spent more dev time fleshing those out, rather than making new environments for each level. Yeah, I don't even know if it's the lack of budget. It was just, I feel like they made this entire game under crunch because they just didn't have a game concept until a few months before, like, maybe they had, like, 9 months to release. This is the level I hated as a kid. I don't remember much about this game as a kid, but I remember despising this level. It took me forever to beat it, and I got a bunch of game overs. Because it's not like the other flying levels. This one you have to hold and lock on and hit him 3 times, I think it is. But all the while you're doing that, you're getting bombarded. Oh, and I think I just went straight into it. Yeah, look at this shit, it's insane! I'm not even going for the gem, I'm just going straight for this ship. Wherever it is, there it is. Still don't like that level, even after knowing what I need to do. I came really close to death like 4 times there. You I don't know if this is a level gimmick or if those scan lines are a problem with the emulator. We'll find out when we get to the real chunk of the level. God, they really tried to hide those things. That's evil. Okay, it was just that section. Hello. That was pretty tight. It's mixed at the moment. There's some good levels in here and some absolute bad stuff in here as well. Like, the underwater sections I was just in have really bad placements for these bomb traps. And the level I did before this was a pain in the ass. But just the running levels are fine. And like, these enemies don't have any threat to them. I can just walk right down this center path and they won't even aim for me. I wouldn't go as far as to say great, but I do like them enough. Oh, no. And like, I just came off playing the original trilogy. Okay, so it's better than Crash 1, but I don't feel that's much of a high bar. Crash 2 and 3 are just much more solid games than this is. In both platforming levels and gimmick levels. I do really like the music for the game though, the music's been great. Yeah, I'm playing the PS2 version on PC. Emulator. Oh god, I wasn't meant to do that. At least, I don't think I was meant to do that. Oh, it's, you kinda need strongish hardware to do it. PC to do it. Yeah, so far I'd put this above Crash 1, mostly because Crash 1's really rough. I'm talking purely the PS1 version of Crash 1, by the way. The N-Sane version of Crash 1 I'd put above this. Yeah, it's still very charming, but just playing it is very rough these days. It doesn't control as well as I'd like, and the save system is really bad. I do appreciate how Crash 1 is, though, since it was the thing that started this entire series. Wow. That slide just went right underneath it. Oh, you wouldn't like my opinion then, because Crash 3 is my absolute favorite game of all time. Yeah, Crash 1's environment design is really good in that way, where it all feels like one connected world. And Crash hasn't done that since. Well, Mind of Mutant did that. Crash 3 is my absolute favorite game ever. I can go back and play Crash 3 as many times as I want, and I'll never get sick of it. I thought I've made that very clear before. Twin Santy is very high up there as well for me. I like Twin Santy a lot. And Crash 2 is just under Crash 3 for me in like how much I like them in the Crash series. I can see why people prefer Crash 2 than Crash 3, but Crash 3 is the one I grew up on and love to death. Yeah, I remember this Wawa fight as well. I remember this being pretty easy to do. It's basically just the entropy fight. Oh no. That wasn't meant to be a slide, that was meant to be a duck. Yeah, the first boss in this was really bad. It took me a few minutes to do. Come on. Oh, wow. I thought I went right over that. Yeah, the first boss is in the ball with some rocks you have to hit. Oh, God. I put my foot in my mouth when I said this is supposed to be easy. Yeah, you'd think I'd learned my lesson by now. Yeah, so, really, I'm streaming this because I want to go through every mainline platformer of Crash before Crash 4 comes out. Which is, like, a day and a half for me. So I've still got to get through this, Twinsanity, and the Titans games. Yeah, it's most people just trash on it. I don't think it's trash. I just think it's underbaked. It's about an average. It could have been a much better game if it wasn't so rushed. Yeah, very middle of the road. But I can see people being upset with middle of the road after the PS1 games. Okay, so they do fall down after a while. Yeah, and after Crash 2 and 3 were great games, going to not bad but not great is a bit off-putting. There we go. Yeah, I like Crunch. He was a good addition. I never really got the hate for Crunch himself.
You are making a mockery of me in front of my minions. Not only have you defeated the elemental masks, but you are still collecting those worthless crystals.
Oh, thank you for the follow.
Well, you've gotten this far, and this is as far as you're gonna get. Pyro, the fire elemental, will see to that.
Oh, Cortex, come on. I don't need some flaming mask to help me. I can take Crunch.
And thank you for
myself.
The follow, too.
Crunch, you will do as I say. You and Pyro will vanquish Crash and his annoying friends.
So, sorry, I'll be about 5-ish minutes. My dog's getting mad. I think he wants to go outside. So, I'll be back. Hey, so I'm back. It wasn't that the dog was needed to go outside. He was hungry. So I just fed him now. And so let's get into the third world now.
I realize my brethren have had some trouble with you, my little orange friend, but I'm not quite sure why. Is it getting hot in here? Is it safe to be wearing that fur? It looks flammable!
Okay, so if it wasn't obvious by his voice alone, Pyro is Mark Hamill. And Tay, if you ask who that is for Mark Hamill, I'm going to be very upset. He's the Joker. Actually, no. But more on brand for myself, he's Goro Majima in the English dub. Really, it was the peak of his career. After Yakuza 1, he went on to do nothing important. I guess the other answer for that, that's very on brand to my likes, is that he's Ericus in Kingdom Hearts. Yeah, all that Disney money went to getting good voice actors. And Birth by Sleep really was just Star Wars versus Star Trek. Oh god. Oh no, there's a little gap there. Okay, much better that time. So a little detail I just noticed because of that death was that the lives icon, when he's alive, it's his eyes are open, but when he's dead, his eyes will shut. It's weird that in a game with not much time for polish has some elements of polish like that for minor UI stuff. Oh, death rap. I'm not really struggling with these death routes, I'm finding. This time I waited till I was done with it before I opened my mouth about it. Yes, Ben. Hold on with your dinner. Oh God, I didn't realize that was coming. Oh God, I wasn't expecting the double jump to take me that far. Just flew over that nitro box and into a pit. That level was fine. Pretty fun. Oh, I remember this level too. The tsunami level is good. I don't like the invincibility theme as much as the original trilogies. It's too underplayed. This is great. Having to use a scooter to escape a tsunami. I guess I'm meant to be pressing something though. I pressed all the buttons and I didn't see anything. Okay, there it is. Circle. Look at it go. And now this simple door is going to stop the tsunami. Let's take this blue path. Since we have it. Where do I go now? I feel like something didn't load in there. Maybe because I hit the nitro switch, it took away some boxes that were there. Yeah, that's what happened. I feel like that's a little poorly designed, putting the nitro switch right next to the blue path, but making the end of the blue path reliant on not hitting the nitro switch. Ah, oh, damn it. Didn't make it far enough. I do want to get through that path, though. Okay, cool. Made it.
For some deep fried bandicoot.
This controls a little loose. Let's try to get in the front though. Ooh. Godlike skills. Oh, I remember people not liking this level. Not not that they don't like the level itself, just that they use the previous game's enemies as obstacles in this, which is kind of shitty. Oh no, right into that hole. Like here, Tiny, what did they do to you? You don't even damage, you just push back. You don't even go all the way over here. You're pathetic. Yeah, them too. And I noticed earlier, Engine was in the plane level as one of the enemy planes. Like, I imagine they wanted to do something with those characters, but they just didn't have the time to do anything with them, so they just threw them in these levels to use the models they made. About to go a little too fast there for my own comfort. The level itself is fine though, this is kind of fun. Never mind. Look at how they massacred my boy. Dingo Dial. Why? Level is trash for ruining Dingo Dial like this. Oh no. Very close to going right off that edge. Oh, no. And then there's Tropy here firing off once every 10 minutes. Jeez, get in there. Here we go. I was curious if there were boxes there, but from using those, but there weren't. Honestly, I would have kind of been better if they didn't use the characters at all, than use them like this, and just made some generic obstacles. God, I'm barely clipping that nitro box. Oh no! No, we're not restarting. I don't care enough to do 100% on this run. I'm just doing up to the first boss fight. And then going straight to Twin Sanity.
Hope you
brought your sunscreen, cause you're gonna burn!
Yeah, exactly. I need to get through Titans and Mind Over Mutant tomorrow. It's just an it was an idea I had of trying to stream all the mainline platformers before Crash 4 comes out. The thing is, I wanted to get a start on the weekend rather than on the Monday, but things came up with my projects that I had to get done, so I couldn't start it till Monday. Because like, even if I got to start these streams on Sunday, it would come out with a better schedule than trying to cram two games into every day. Yeah, still pretty brutal. Oh, I didn't realize that steam was an obstacle. I remember that invisibility box. Damn it. You know what? Losing the golden Aku Aku isn't worth it. And I just lost him. Oh god. Yeah, it would have just been nice to have for the boss fights, having the extra hit points. Oh, just barely clipped it. Yeah, I played the originals on the PS1 versions instead of the N-Sane version. Like, the day Crash 4 was announced, I went through and played through the N-Sane trilogy on my own. So I felt like playing the PS1 versions this time. Probably not. I know, right? How dare I play Crash and not something like Spyro? But yeah, I probably won't be going on to N-Sane after Mind Over Mutant just because of time. By the time I finish Titans and Mind Over Mutant, Crash 4 will be coming out over here. Oh, I always liked this part of this level. Oh really? Why is that? Ah, at least not yet. Ah, right. Yeah, I've seen some people say they don't think $60 is worth it for the game. I'll be getting a day one though. Okay, so the opposite of the last boss fight, I'm gonna say this one actually gave me a lot of shit as a kid.
Ah, the triumphant hero Crash, reduced to a pile of smoldering ash.
Let's finish this.
I never liked this boss fight as much as I wanted to. Yeah, the music's great. So I'm pretty sure I did something wrong there. There we go. Okay, so I gotta spray him when I get closer. Spraying it slows me down. Those always got me. and I didn't get close enough. Damn it. I'm probably being too overly cautious about those pebbles. There we go. Got him that time. Damn it! Oh no! I jumped too early. Oh boy. I really don't like that boss fight. Yeah, it is.
Cortex! Why is that mindless marsupial still collecting those crystals? He's defeated Rocco and Wawa! I'm beginning to question the value of your super weapon!
I don't need another mask's help. I could take this Crash Punk out with my metal arm tied behind my back!
Oh, Crunch, stop being silly. Uka, He will use the elemental masks. No need for you to lose any beauty sleep.
The Crash Bandicoot, eh? Oh, I've heard so much about you, and this is the hero I have to blow away? Ha! Seems like a bunch of hot air to me.
So this mask is Lolo, he's voiced by Jess Harnell, who is now currently the voice actor for Crash. Yeah, I think his design might have changed a little bit between games. Yeah, but everyone changed a lot for Titans. He got basically an entire personality change for Titans as well. Oh god, I thought I'd bounce off that TNT. Yeah, they didn't really get a lot of screen time in the Titans games. And out of all the personality changes, Tiny probably got it the worst. I still don't know what they were going for with him. Yeah, Brio came out good in Mind Over Mutant. Oh no, I missed one. Yeah, seeing how they handled would have handled Tropy might have been interesting. Mostly because Brio came out for the better once they got the hang of it. Okay, I'll be 2 seconds. There's something I want to quickly check. because I'm getting a little worried about this potentially crashing on me. Okay, cool. Got it all sorted out. Oh no. One moment. Okay, so it was just my controller came unplugged. Nothing major. Oh jeez, started getting worried there. Pinstripe doesn't get enough love. He was only in the first game and then he won Torna. And that's it. I guess he was in his boss fight in CTR as well. Oh god, no. This is so dangerously slow. Did they keep the ducking? Yeah, they kept the ducking for this. Yeah, Koala Kong deserved a little bit more love too. Okay, it's not an enemy doing that. Yeah, I can see Tiny being the replacement for Koala Kong. God, why would they make it so slow, but do a timing puzzle on that? Oh, oof. That is not good. Okay, let me quickly have a look if there's a fix for this. Okay, I fixed it, but the picture quality went down a shit ton. It'll be fine. I can fix it up. I can change the thing after this level. God, this doesn't aim anywhere near as good as the bazooka did. There we go. Listen, I saw that picture of Coco and I knew I had to use it for the Be Right Back screen, knowing I'd have to go on break every now and then. The one I picked up for Twin Sanity is also very good. It's perfectly fine, but not really. It's terrifying. Oh gosh, no. That tiny shot took down this entire mech. God, this doesn't control well at all. Oh God. Oh jeez. That tiny corner. There we go. Oh God. There we go. I almost fell for that pit.
Is there a draft in here?
God, that one sucks. Take down all these barriers first while I'm going around. Was that Rillaroo? That one was tiny. Nah, this isn't as cool as the gummy ship. You need to see the gummy ship in the games after Kingdom Hearts 1. Oh, right, the picture quality. There we go. I'd say it's really good in 2 and 3 though. Oh god, mines. Okay, good night. Sweet dreams. Oh god, I heard it coming and I thought it would be a little bit ahead. Yes, Bandit. What's the matter? Come here. Oh no, where's the checkpoint? I really do not like the design of these subsections. Yeah, that's kind of the impression I'm getting, where all the gimmick levels have been taken out for in favor of Torna, Cortex, and Dingo Dial levels. I haven't seen much to do in terms of gimmick stuff in Crash 4 at all. We have seen a tiny, tiny shot of animal riding being back in Crash 4. Actually, I just got very curious about that because in the trailer it shows Crash riding on Polar. And I'm just wondering now if you use Coco for that level, if you'll ride Puro instead. Yeah, that's what I'm thinking too. They're looking more towards making a really solid platforming experience, like Crash 2. Which isn't a bad decision at all. God damn, that crushing. Yeah, I can understand why people would prefer that. I like it a lot myself, but I do like the overall, I do like what the gimmicks give Crash Free in some versatility departments. And, like, I'm just a big general fan of the gimmick levels in Crash 3. Like, I really enjoy the motorbike levels and the plane levels. I'm just getting destroyed in this level. Right at the end too. Jeez.
Not used to the weather here, I a wimp.
Yeah, these quips from the bosses suck. You don't get anything out of them at all. Oh God, why?
Is
These hang bar sections are nowhere near as good as they were before. They're way too slow. Power up just decided it didn't want to work anymore. Oh no. I forgot I have the tornado spin now. Oh jeez, I thought I'd make it in time. Oh shit. Oh, shit. They're going to be announcing a new Smash character in the morning. 7 a.m. PT tomorrow. Okay, let's try to make this. You know, I'd like it to be an interesting pick, like, someone with an axe or a spear. But it'll probably just be, Lin. No, wait, is Lin an assist trophy in Smash Ultimate? I don't think she is, so she could make it.
Hey, look! The orange boy likes to fly!
Time to earn your wings, kid!
And, like, that isn't even bad-mouthing Lin. I like her. But, it'd just be another sword. Even if it is a katana. Yeah, yeah, they do. Actually, if they knew their audience, they wouldn't have done Byleth, they would have done Edelgard. Yeah, they do. I haven't had the money to get the new season pass myself. Min Min was a good choice for me, so I still want to get it for that. Oh, he's mixing up the pattern now. Usually he'd go for the head. Let's get another save in.
Well, here we are again. I wouldn't necessarily call this irony, but don't you find it a little odd that we keep meeting under these same world domination circumstances? Why not just give up? And let me win for once!
Don't worry, Dr. Cortex. Now that my elemental powers have reached maximum capacity, this little geek is gonna wish he was never created.
Oh god. I'm just gonna long jump to that. That was a mistake. Oh god. I'm just running into everything now. Oh, that's dark for a Crash game. That's probably a death route. Something I'm noticing now that I'm near the end of the game is that none of the levels seem to really take advantage of the power-ups like they did in Crash 3. There's a couple of points where you need to use a sneaking to get through Nitro Bridges. But I don't feel like there's ever been anything that's really been like, oh, here's a double jump challenge or a Death Tornado Spin challenge. And even then, the Tornado Spin in this game doesn't keep your altitude like it did in Crash 3. You start descending way faster. I remember, like, in Crash 3, like, as soon as you get a Death Tornado Spin, the first level has that alternate path on the left to where you have to use it to get across. Oh, what happened there? Yeah, I feel like you could put any of these levels in any order and they'd all feel about the same. None of these levels need to be in the hub world they're in. They could be in any point and you wouldn't miss anything. And, like, I'm fine with some levels being that way, but it'd be nice to have a handful of levels that are like, hey, you just got this power-up, use the power-up to progress. Why did I do that? God, these monkey bar sections are horrible. Okay, almost done. 3 more levels.
Bring it, great dead bandicoot.
Oh, God. Doing that U-turn sucks. Every time I keep go careening off. Oh god, okay. One more try, and if I fall off again, I'm not gonna bother with the gem. hasn't been a checkpoint yet. That's upsetting me. Oh no! Me and my big mouth. And the checkpoint was right after I said that too. Jeez. Hi Tiny, bye Tiny. Oh, I remember this section as a kid. From when I was a kid. Specifically that part where you had to just go on a slanted angle and try to get past Ingridale and Trophy. Crystal. 5 boxes. Let's quickly save. Oh God. Oh, this music's good. I like that beat. I'm worried for the next level because this sounds like final level music. Guess I'm dead. Oh god. Oh, lordy. Let's fix that back up. Yeah, I don't know what causes it. It's something about the mech levels. Well, not just the mech levels, because the swimming levels had the same issue, but not as bad. Cortex Vortex.
Crash, you've been a naughty boy. But now that's going to end.
Oh god, why did I do that? I'd pull away just in time. Okay. That's just the level. The emulator fucking up. I thought I was being chased. Because usually this running towards the camera is saved for chase sequences. Wow, they're not as threatening as they are in Crash 2. Oh, this level's not being friendly. Okay, let's fix this up. Oh, I thought I'd make it onto that platform. Okay, I did that time and he just slipped off. Oh god, why did I do that? Oh, that's bullshit. I spun them. Alright, that's that half done. Let's check my gems for a moment. Okay, no, I don't have all the color ones. Kaiser, I think your idea about the levels being in just random places and didn't have much consistency of progression might be on point, because usually those last levels have a multicolored gem path, and that one was just a green path. Yeah, it really should be, but it didn't feel like it. And like I said, the level before that had more of a final level Crash. Feeling for its music than that one did.
Not only have you collected all the crystals in record time, but you also defeated the elementals. Let Crunch and me be the first ones to congratulate you.
By pummeling your sand, Bandicoot frame into a pup. Come and get it.
Yeah, that's the way it feels. I remember this final boss sucking. Please stop.
Can't you ever let me win? What do you want from me, you cretin?
Cortex! You realize that Crash may have collected all the crystals, but he doesn't have the gems. With the gems, we can resurrect the masks one last time and destroy that bandicoot once and for all.
The final hit wasn't very climactic. Yeah, no, I surprisingly did that very well. That was indeed a game. So, I do want to save it after this is done, so I'll let the credits roll, and then I'm going to chuck on a video of what the final ending looks like, just so we can roll from the final ending into Twinsanity. But yeah, Wrath of Cortex, I guess what Teja said, that's a game. That's about all I can say to sum it up. It wasn't bad, but it wasn't as good as the PS1 games. It's just kinda here. Yeah, the true ending isn't anything fully special. But let's go save it. And let's pull up my screen. Alright.
Can't you ever let me win? What do you want from me, you cretin? No, Uka Uka, I can explain.
It's too late for that now!
I don't think you should have done that.
Oh, no. Where am I?
giant scientist doesn't have control over me anymore. Where is that pathetic twerp?
There's no time for that now, Crunch.
Danger. Critical power overload in Evil Space Station. Run for your lives.
I think your energy bolt caused a slight chain reaction. It might be wise if we made our way to the escape pods.
This is all your fault! If you hadn't ducked out of the way, none of this would have happened!
This doesn't look good. I'm grateful to all of you. If it weren't for you, I'd still be under the control of Dr. Cortex. Thank you for believing in me, guys.
You're welcome, Crunch. Hey, do you think that's the last we'll see of Dr. Cortex and Uka Uka?
I'd like to believe that, my children. But somehow, I doubt that very much.
Idiot! Fool! Nincompoop! You've landed us in the middle of nowhere!
Ouch! Whoa! No, wait! I can explain! I'll get my revenge, Crash Bandicoot! Just you wait!
And that's the ending of the game. I don't know. They didn't do anything at all. They just kind of beat him senseless until the game was done. Okay, so I'm going to take like a fiver just to go get a drink and stretch for a moment before I start up to insanity. And in the meantime, enjoy the new Be Right Back screen.